Hi, everybody. I hope you all had a great Thanksgiving despite all the challenges. And as a matter of fact, I wanted to talk to you about that very thing. In the past few weeks, I have been one of the victims of COVID. On October 30th was the only time that I ever went out. And the reason I'm sharing this is because I want you to know how highly contagious this is. I wear my mask everywhere. I went to a restaurant outdoors with some family, four of us, everybody was negative, and we wore masks all the way to the table. And when we left, the only thing that I can imagine happened is that someone came up to me when I was eating and tapped me on the shoulder. They were very close. They had no mask and they were telling me beautiful things, but that's the only thing that I have done outside of my enclosure here, my quarantine with everybody and the studio with everybody there is negative as well. On November the 5th, the reason that I realized that I had COVID was because my poor chef was the victim of me telling her that the chicken that she made me tasted like nothing. I still didn't realize it till the next day when my breakfast tasted like nothing, and then my soap I couldn't smell, and then I started freaking out a little bit like we all have been, because the fear is the biggest part of this whole thing. I asked to get tested, and that Sunday, I guess it was November 8th, I was positive. I locked myself away on the second floor of my house, didn't let anybody up for 2 weeks. I can tell you that fortunately, I'm very lucky that the only symptoms that I had were the loss of smell and taste and a little bit of a cough. I can't say that I felt bad. I really, you know, but my immune system is always firing on all pistons. I take very good care of it, which is also something I want to share with you, because for years I've been taking extra D3. I take, you know, almost 6,000 units of the D3. I'm taking zinc. I've always take my vitamins. I take extra C, which all of that is very useful for anybody that may be having that now. My good friend, the infectious disease doctor, Dr. Eileen Marty, told me that melatonin is very good for the immune system, or the connection with your brain and your immune system. So I was taking 10 milligrams of melatonin at night. I don't like to say brands, but Listerine Coolmint apparently kills this thing. So use that a lot to protect yourself. What else? A lot of Gatorade Zero, no sugar, and hydrates you well, which I did get a little bit dehydrated. And I just want to say that I'm very thankful. I have so much to be thankful for. I've already tested negative twice last week. And the reason that I didn't share while I was going through it is I didn't want you guys worrying about me needlessly, or to mess up your Thanksgiving, or to take attention away from Nurse Heroes, that amazing show that Emilio put together for all our incredible nurses that have been putting their lives on the line for all of us. And right now, I know we're kind of in a very big spike in Miami. It's tough here now. The hospitals are reaching, you know, they're full. And these are the people that are really suffering from the very, you know, tough cases of COVID. I was very lucky. But I just wanted to share with you that the fact I was in quarantine, and one day I went out and met with one person that was not wearing a mask. I even held my breath, quite honestly, through their talk, but something must have happened there, because I really have been nowhere else that it could have happened. I've been locked up, and thank God that I wear a mask. My friend, the doctor, said maybe I got a very low viral dose, which may be why the symptoms were like that, you know, not so difficult. She said it very clearly. She goes, if you're in a war, it's not the same thing being attacked by 500 soldiers as it is by 10. So please, everybody, wear your masks, you know, try to stay 6 feet away and protect yourselves as well as you could. But also those of you that may be having this, fear was my biggest problem, because since we don't know what's going to happen, and sometimes you really get very afraid if you're going to be one of those cases. But, you know, we've got to grab fear and shake it, and, you know, just do whatever you can to keep your immune system as healthy as you can. I also use B12 sublingual drops under my tongue, which is good for your immune system. I've been doing this for years, so maybe that's also the reason that I was so lucky with this. But anyway, I just wanted you to know. just in case I can be helpful in whatever way. I love you all. Stay healthy, stay safe, and looking forward to a better year next year for sure. I love you all. Bye.